you for being here. Marvin, Daniel Marvin, and then we've got Jeff Belbey, and then we've got the Kamikaze Mix. Put your hands together right now for our feature this evening. He's going to do a little bit here and a little bit there.
Oh, cool.
But this is the first time that you'll get to experience Mr. Keith Savage this tonight. And if you haven't experienced him before, you're in for something special. Please put your hands together, everybody, for Mr. Keith Savage!
I want to have accompaniment by Mr. Jeff Belbey, Mr. Bryan Harrison.
Yay, cool.
Belbey's getting his things together down there. When I first Miss Sherry Noel was running the open mic down here, I was stationed down at Paradise Lounge. She invited me down here to check out her open mic, and when I got down here, it was all right. You know, I said, yeah, the Hotel Utah is a nice little spot, but you know, I really like the Paradise Lounge better, so I'll stay down at Paradise Lounge and just visit the Hotel Utah now and again. So, as time went on, then Mr. De La Soul started hosting open mic down here, and I left town for a while, and I came back after leaving the Paradise Lounge, and she said, you know, they're gonna try to take this open mic away from us down here. It's been going on for about 12 years, and the new owners want to get rid of the open mic. So that's when we put together the Challenge 2000 contest and showed them what we can do the best. And then the owners said, well, we want you guys to stay. So we ended up booting them out of the way. So we're here with brand new owners that said, we're gonna keep the open mic at the Hotel Utah. So this Challenge 2002 contest we're having is actually an anniversary of the one that saved the open mic. But what you guys don't know, what I just found out today is, of the three owners that bought this place, one of them dropped out. And she says, I'm gonna sue you and take everything away because I don't want the open mic in there. I want it out of here. I'm not making any money in this business. I want to get something going on. So you guys, you all got to go. So once again, we're in that situation where we're going to fight for this open mic. And the Challenge 2002 contest is not to keep the open mic this time, because we got two strong owners that are going to hold on to this. This Challenge 2000 is for you, to bring exposure to you. And that's what this whole information package that's going to Oprah Winfrey and Ricky Lake is all about. They're talking about the send-off party for Keith Savage. Well, it's the send-off party for the tapes I did here, for the videos, speaking right here on this stage, talking about how we need to get ahead, how we need to be number one, how we need to be known all over the world and not just sitting here at the Hotel Utah. They're going to send that package off so that Oprah Winfrey can take a look at it, so that Ricky Lake can take a look at it. Because we know that the Hotel Utah is a place where miracles happen. This is a place where amazing things happen, where astounding things happen, where we were not only able to save the open mic, but we were able to kick the people out of here that tried to kick us out. And you see this magazine on the floor. It's Oprah Winfrey magazine. This woman here was not even supposed to be on television. She was supposed to be in the alleyways. She was supposed to be just a garbage picker or just a prostitute. At one time, she was even homeless. But now, in the year 2000, she was worth $6.2 million. $6.2 billion. Billion, not million, billion dollars. That's what we saved this open mic again. Now, if she can get her own magazine, if she can get her own television show, if she gets $6.2 billion, then where's our magazine at? Where's our money at? There's $5 million right here in the first row. $5 million worth of music talent right here. And I'm not even talking about on the back wall. So there's no reason for us to fall. No reason for us to give up. We're gonna hold this open mic. We're gonna hold this hotel. I want us to buy this entire building. They're only talking about $2 million, but maybe we can knock it down to $1 million. It was $3 million, but like I said, it's $5 million sitting in the front row. So why don't we buy this Hotel Utah and turn it into a music studio and make it a performing arts center? I'm talking about going all the way, just like the Beatles did. Just like everybody else that ever hit the stage. Yeah, some fell by the wayside, but that's because they didn't have the mood, the will, or the ambition to strive. We got to move forward. We can't give up now. We got to keep on going and show these people that we have power. Willie Brown tried to throw us out, but we're still here now. They tried to kick us out of all the studios in town, but we're still here now. And I'm saying we're not giving up, and we're not going down, but we're gonna be number one in America and number one in the rest of the world, because they're gonna know about the Hotel Utah when we let our music flag unfurl. So all you got to do is stick with me, and I'll be coming up later on tonight 5 or 6 more times with other music to bring to your site. What we're gonna do this time, how we're gonna make it work for us in America, how we're gonna make this the best place to be, the Hotel Utah in the land of the free. And I'm talking about you and me going all the way into ecstasy. We are the best in the world, so we have to let the rest of the people know that we are right here to start the show, and we're not gonna go. Yes, the Hotel Utah, today, tomorrow, and forever.
Guy in between. Give it up for Mr. Key Savage. You got a taste of what Key has offered. I think there's a lot of talk in this world, and I think that's good. I think that creates what's going to be generated and what people are going to take action on to have the lives that they want and the lives they want for their community and everyone in their community and the world. And then there are people who talk, and then they back it up, and they go out in the community, and they bring what they're talking about to the people. Keith has gone into schools. He's brought musicians into schools into San Francisco, and he's had these musicians play for children in school, and he's brought poetry and music into schools. They don't have music programs.
I know, no arts and sciences anymore. Or yeah. Humanities.
Not traditionally, yeah. But thanks to Keith, we had those.
Yeah.
So give it up for Keith Savage. That's just a glimpse of what he's got. And we'll hear more from him later. If you haven't met Keith, or if you want to acknowledge him for anything, or talk to him, he'll be walking around all night. And if he's not, if you can't find him anywhere, he'll be right here. But he's kind of on, he's pretty popular tonight. He's always popular, but tonight, extra popular. So you have to take a number. All right, we've got Jeff Belbey on deck, and then we've got the Kamikaze Mix, followed by Andy, and then Opiate Void. Put your hands together right now for Mr. J. Neo Marvin! The Bionic Man, Mr. Steve Arnsten.
Yeah, woo!
Pain in the ass, pain in the ass.
I can't work under these conditions.
This equipment
rocks. Give it up for the equipment.
equipment here.
Yeah, equipment.
Yeah, microphone.
Okay.
Most of it is excellent. Look, we have a new board.
Yay.
This one's on. Steve Arnsten is joining me tonight on this song.
Yes,
yeah.
Lucky you. Hey, Steve, it's not even him.
No, I think I'm on.
I can't.
And this is called Fiscal Year Zero. Is the guitar on yet? Oh, no, I'm starting to hear it. Okay.
Still the crowd persists in believing in the king.
for the next big scam. It's bound to be coming soon. If we all agree this scenario is real, we'll see Tinkerbell alive again. Ah, the vigilante saddle up bear mules, every man to his own agenda. We didn't start the fire, we only provide the gasoline. Won't some cowboy in a china shop loves the sound of breaking glass? When every man is king, someone still has to play the role of the servant class. Tell us about it, Steve. Are awesome, but the hero is not exactly convincing. We've burned all our history books to keep warm. Now the news looks like science fiction. And the acts human beings are capable of are forever beyond description. You're either on the bus or you're off of the bus. The driver's voice crackles through the speakers as the highway to hell unfolds like a yellow brick road. We're checking the map as we quell our reservations with biker crank and Prozac. 99 bottles of something unspeakable on the wall. Take one down. Pass it around.
Neo Marvin, everybody. Give it up for Neo Marvin and Steve Arnsten on piano.
That was fun.
That looked fun.
Neo, you're one of the most amazing writers.
Yeah. Really. Aw, shucks.
Really, yeah.
That's right. That's
you're one of the most amazing MCs, Bob.
That's your show.
And now you know why I like people. I don't know, forget. Alright, give it up one more time for Mr. Neo Marvin. So he's got CDs over there, and they're amazing. The musicians that he plays with are amazing.
Still at the amazing price of $5.
And still, at $5 still?
$5.
Yeah.
Wow. And that's not all! You also get this next performer free! I wouldn't classify myself as the leader, but I...
But you are.
Creator.
I work with it, you know, put a little duct tape on it here. Yes, try to put it together. I think it was another person that was on vocals. I haven't seen her unless she's in the bathroom. Okay. I'm a person or something.
A person?
Yeah. What's your name?
Do we have a female vocalist or someone?
Someone
once? Okay. Well,
I think so. It was like sometimes when we're out.
What's that?
I've got to grab like one more person. And we have someone for the piano.
public. How did it sound in the audience? Did you hear much piano?
He needs a piano player. Oh yeah, you can hear it.
Okay, well, we'll watch the videotape later.
He needs a piano player, by the way. I don't know if you want to volunteer for Kamikaze.
He's too shy for that.
I don't really know.
On stacking, yet he continues to spill, his focus retracting. Shills reap unpacking his wallet. He'll refuse to be still, he'll give it to strangers. The nuts on the street, his friends said so deeply concerned in living the dangers and the ruts incomplete. What ends for what dreams none have learned? They all think he's lost. The folks know so long, it's hardly the one that they knew. I'm a straight man, he's tossed it. No jokes blown, long gone in the yard, he just sits there. Talking to someone that we cannot see, his demeanor now calm and serene, while walking with no one, they plan what's to be, so foreseen, yes, he's calm, physically. He's been touched, he now know in a way now so blessed, mistaken his rising so true, he's now clutched, now aglow, yesterday none had guessed, now awakened, now I'm revised and now new. Said when he came back inside. We hold, we now know what he lives to restore, what we've read about. Something disturbed your poems and hateful. Please tell us now why you appear to remain so perturbed. It's that I'm born here. You wouldn't understand the native, he states to the blind, but I still accept beer. So flatly deadpan and moving closer, blowing quiet fog. No one's from here. She says with a shrug, you're the first one I've ever met. Her naive and clear, still the proud one-time pug. He's repulsed at her lack of regret, so he's puts down his drink to gather his things. Then on stage stands the hippie from days, the boxer they think went all home. I run to the beach, past the sun soon to reach, on my knees, crying now, oh God, please, trying how, maniacs, no one there, plain the facts, none comparable to hell, everything, known you well, never bring peace on earth, none to change, Christian burn, Muslim strange, told before, you can think, told just swore. No more hate. Be allowed, nor create, be a crowd. spoken for weeks, or perhaps it's been months. While suffering, I'll say, a spirit so broken as he speaks, that perhaps he confronts. Glad you're all right, we were praying, you know, the good bishop told me relieved. The Lord had his mind be saying to show your face so that it thus be received. My causes are noble, I tell my best friend, this man who takes outcasts aside. But the cops chase me global and compel me to send to the can for mistakes and no pride. Bishop, listen again to my woes, for that there can be no compare to Mick. Pick up his missing friend, then he knows the brat he must handle with care. And the bishop assumes I leave a lot out of my stories for reasons of guilt. For the slip-ups, the fumes, all the peeves I do, shoutless the glories. Through seasons, so built. But he stops short of prying his hopes that I'll soon pay a visit and find peace of mind. And perhaps then stop trying to tie ropes around the moon. So exquisite, this humble design. White collar car, little flag waving bitch, acting as if you would go, you the right, you the drunk, you the brag, breaking rich, you extracting this rent, we should know and see our own city. So great, they're inviting the ones who declared it for day by the three, by committee, so shaken, so divided, so smoke, so unfair, so portrayed, I'm more than taken, I don't fucking yank. It's got him a dead bitch, it's out, controlling the paper, that's true. Lucky thanks, must do not feel the thing, this is now. For reflection to bear. And sang rang him bugging that cell tensy roll. Go below the detection, he there. So stealth his persona, he slips in behind that old double rock, seeking surprise. No health, marijuana, he skips, but he beeline for that cub, so shot shrieking goodbyes. From this kill, it's so easy, he's back telling Scratchy, his mom and your brother so poor, no less ill. No more sleazy, and he's thanked well to catch this common little villain. Once more. City not hit, he heard on the box, his TV in the world, he might know. What a pity. What shit, and a tear. Then I locks them to see, so we pearl the white glow, the new peace. No danger, no death yet attached to me, from that call seeking out. Oh, as for you, recent stranger, you know, breath been so catched, you so great no more. Oh, speak and shout. Too late, white boy! Captured and surrounded by they, Americans. Be one and all, true fate, joy, and rapture, plan sure, bound to pay for and scared, you can see. None at all. But the poor folk for life here, plainly, see must have believed, not the lies, the press tell. And they roar, vocal by fear, or insanely be just. Thought, they devise, contrast.
We have Dennis Desiree in the poet, and then we have
Arthur,
and I think he has CDs for sale in his pocket.
Hey, I like those CDs.
I'll be featured here August 5th, so dress appropriately. There'll be bars up on the window and probably some broken glass. Enjoy.
Oh man. No, that's embarrassing. I hate it when that happens. I just fucking hate it. Key. Also, it's a real pleasure to be here back at the Utah. You know, I think y'all can empathize. We all like to play the big rooms, right? And this is a big room. See, that's what happens to people that don't eat their vegetables right there. Example A. So, you know, my complaint before I perform anywhere is, before I get over here tonight, I did not get my nap, and I always want to get my nap before I perform because I want to be fresh and rested. But tonight, I got that nap. So if I blow, can't blame it on that. So, you know, an optimist may know that the glass is half full. However, a pessimist will mention the glass is half empty. You know, a realist will realize that somebody, somewhere, is half drunk. An optimist will mention the glass is half full. A pessimist will say the glass is half empty. But I say the glass is not living up to its potential. You can do better. Y'all want to know how to draw a blank?
Do you want to read from the Tree of Lies?
Look into my mind. It's a... okay, I guess I'm going to give you a New Year's resolution. Well, the June-July nexus makes the halfway point this year. At least this year it makes the halfway point. And with that, I want to give you an update on my New Year's resolution for this year. What was it? Number one, my first New Year's resolution was to...
Be funny.
Thank you. Somebody's paying attention here. Very good. So, I don't know. How am I doing? See, I just said it. This is the year I'm going to do it. I'm going to be funny. So pay attention. You didn't pay admission, right? My second New Year's resolution this year was I plan on losing a little weight. I want to deflate this tire right here, see? I know where I fucked up, I think, is when I quit smoking. That's when I really lost it. Because,
Right,
thank you.
Oh,
man, I'm done. I guess I did lose. I guess I didn't get my nap tonight. So anyhow, let me see. Number three was I resolved this year to have sex with somebody.
Somebody else?
Somebody else. Precise. Very good. You're getting your protein. Because all the time, there's just me. And I deserve better. This year I resolved I ain't gonna take no shit from nobody. This year's a shit free year, right? I'm gonna take no shit from nobody.
Oh, yeah.
Got that? No shit from nobody. No fucking shit from nobody.
That means you're taking shit
and
from
then
everybody.
Failing that, I just hope it don't
double
step in
negative.
Me. Hey, I'll tell you what, we have the, what's the term, I can't remember, I say how much I fuck with the internet. Have the interactive question and answer when I'm right after I'm done, so hold your question till the end, okay? Fucking people. So, what was it, Steve Fawcett finally crossed, the first time in six tries he crossed his imaginary finish line last, what was it, Wednesday, I guess, in Kalgoorlie, Australia, and then he just kept on flying. It wouldn't come down. This guy got it up and wanted to keep it up.
Wah, wah.
That's my dick joke. Go to the Bible. Why is it always blanking my sabers?
You missed rehearsal?
Okay, yeah, I missed rehearsal. Okay. So, this guy, he got it up and couldn't get it down. He's like, I guess he kept on going. He wanted to recircle the world twice. And
So, you know, he's over there in Western Australia, and it's all flat. Steve, coming down crashing should be the least of your problems, okay? I also read in the paper where this guy had military rations, bottled oxygen, and a bucket.
Ooh.
So here we got this guy flying around doing this. We have this flying around, and we got that flying down. Get in the car.
Get in the car. Give it up for Andy.
I just swallowed a whole fry.
Chew 'em, dude. Oh wait, it's not my turn. Oh, speaking of get in the car. When I don't get my nap, I get all dyslexic. Warning midnight before your car move if you're parked on Bryant, the other side of Bryant, or on the other side of 4th.
Yes.
Otherwise, ticket will you get.
When?
Midnight.
Yes, Yoda.
Yoda. Yeah. So, put your hands together, everybody, for Andy one more time. Either he's getting funny or I'm just getting used to him. He is. I thought it was that, but maybe I'm warped. Nah. Give it up for Opiate Void. I need somebody that knows a trivia question, actually, while they're setting up real quick.
Here, how about the Tree of Lies?
I don't know. Is somebody going to be able to answer that one?
Well, they're...
It's not really a trivia. Please welcome Davis Jones! And that...
Is it in hand?
Yes. Find food!
Alright, so this is what you're supposed to do with these. You're supposed to, on a scale of 1 to 5, tell me if you have a weak reaction or a strong reaction to these lies, okay? And you can like go boo for ones and bah for fives. Okay, so 27, lie number 27. The most humane thing to do for a dying man is to convince him that he served a noble purpose. Okay? Number 32, self-acceptance is based, remember these are lies, self-acceptance is based on self-contempt. Weak reaction. Morality allows the exploited the opportunity to feel noble. Lies, they're lies. The best way to measure a man is to give him what he wants. They like that one. Are we ready yet?
So who did like that one? Anybody?
What is
nobody
the
like that one? You like that one?
Okay, good.
You want a CD? Here you go. Ready? A Clever Girl CD to the winner of that marvelous question.
Now, if he doesn't want it, doesn't like it, give it to somebody who might.
You can't. If you don't want it, and if you don't like it, give it to someone who might.
That's the only rule.
That's the only rule. And please, thank Karen S., the Baroness Karen S., a.k.a. Clever Girl, for donating one of her very last CD tonight. Give it up for Karen S. Thank you.
until they're ready to go. Ladies and gentlemen, we are Opiate Void. There you go, Dave.
Hey!
We are Opiate Void.
Tomanonymous.
Yeah.
And Earl.
I'll go get it.
You get everyone.
I'll go get it.
No, I'm not going out. I'm sure. That's what I'm going to say. How do you stop it?
Well, you don't have to stop it, but you have to, like, if you want, you can zoom in. Yeah. But if you do zoom in, you have to, like,
Well,
how do you end the zoom?
The other way.
I went.
Like it's 11 o'clock.
I went. This weekend, Sunday, I went to Amoeba Music.
Yeah.
To see Puff. Amy Yumi from Japan. Two girls who are scheduled to be the next Britney Spears. Already bigger than Britney Spears or bigger than Madonna in Japan right now. Sold 14 million records. 14 million records. So I went over there to check them out and see what it's all about. I read about them in the paper, I saw their pictures, they looked very cute, and I said, well, I'm gonna check these girls out and see what they got to offer. After all, I do like the Spice Girls. So I said, maybe I can relate to this Japanese rock they got to offer over here. Well, when they came out, I got to admit that they were looking kind of tired. They looked like they had been herded like cattle and driven across streams and climbing over mountaintops and herded across the land. They were tired looking. They put on a nice performance, but it wasn't earth shattering. It's not the type of thing to tear the roof off or something. But I could tell by the way they put the performance on that they were real tired. They were worn out. And I could see by the expression on their faces they were saying that they didn't want to perform the way they were doing that, but somebody was handling them and telling them to do it just that way. I could see that they wanted to perform like we perform here. And in essence, what their faces told me and the way they were expressing themselves was they wish they could be right here at the Hotel Utah performing with the greatest in the world. So we can have that heart-to-heart relationship. So we can be face-to-face. So we can be hand-to-hand. So we can be man-to-woman. So we can be here together. I saw there we had 500 people at Amoeba Music. And the people were there because everybody else was there. They didn't really know why they were there. Their friends said, let's go, and they went there. But where they really wanted to be was here, because here we have the connection. Here we have the people ready to receive what they believe in. They know what we're talking about. They can feel it. The music is here in the soul. Yes, Puffy, Emmy, Yumi lacked that soul experience. They didn't have that closeness. They didn't have that togetherness that we have here. They were missing that. And as soon as their performance was over, they ran in the back. The man had to say, well, they'll be back out later to sign autographs, but you got to let them relax. Because they couldn't stand it. They couldn't stand the corporate industry holding them down and telling them what to say. Go here, go here, go there, do this, do that. Act thin, act fat. Smile, 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 don't forget to smile. No, they just wanted to cut loose, lay back, and be like everybody else. See, Madonna, she got a chance to do that, because she told them, F you, I'm going to do what I want to do. But these girls didn't have that type of power, didn't have that dynamics. And don't even think about Elvis, because see, Elvis had cool. Elvis had cool. Cool, that's what Elvis was. A lot of musicians and performers wish they could have that cool. Now, Jerry Lee Lewis, he didn't need the cool, because he acted like a fool. He can do what he want to do. But Elvis had cool. So fight out there, he said, look, I'm gonna be cool. If he had to fight, he said, I'm gonna fight cool. If he lose, I'm gonna lose cool. But see, Elvis didn't have to lose because Elvis was cool. So you see, they were missing that cool too. And they wish they could be here with us. But they don't have to wait long. If we can just stay strong and get out there in the world and let them know what they're missing here in this house. If we can just let them see it, just let them touch it, just let them taste just a piece of it, then they'll understand what it's all about. They'll understand what it is to be cool like Elvis. They'll understand what it is to be a fool like Jerry Lee Lewis. Because we got that in this house. We got every range of music, every mind, every mood, and we can use it. We are the best in the world. All we have to do is let them know it. We can show it. Oh yes, I'm talking about performance. I'm talking about rising up a new day and a new dawn. I'm talking about telling people what it's all about here. Why are you fighting a war out there when you can be in here dancing and singing? Why are we in this little place when we can have a big, big, big hall? We come here once a week just to confer, just to transfer information on. But all during the rest of the week, we can be dancing somewhere, you understand? A great big hall. We can be circling the world. We can be putting parties on all over the United States of America. Why are they holding us back? Why won't they give you a chance? Because you're not Puffy, Amy, Yumi. Because they can't control you. And since they can't control you and hold you down, they said, well, we just won't recognize them. Keep it shh, quiet, shh, quiet, real quiet, so nobody knows that they even exist. Let them crawl around like ants out there, and people will just step right over them and won't even know about them, won't even hear their music. But we're about to make a change now. We're about to put Bob O'Magic in action. We're gonna let Bob take our music out there and spread it around.
Hey, Bob.
Live. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna come live, all the way live. I myself have command of a little bit of money. And what we're gonna do is, we're gonna take this money and we're gonna duplicate the very same CDs that Bob O'Magic puts together to play here. I'm talking about the Hotel Utah mix. And after we put those mixes together, you understand, and we multiply and replicate those CDs, we're gonna take them out there and we're gonna sell them. We're gonna distribute them. We might even give some away for free. And we're gonna let these people know that we got this music here. And we got these musicians here just waiting to come out. And we're gonna use that idea that De La Soul had before she left here. We're gonna go play out there in front of their theaters, out there in front of their shows, out on the sidewalk, and let the people know that you may have something inside to know, but you got something better out here. We'll play in the park. We'll get some of those little, small, quiet generators so we can pump up our sound and let the people know that we're in this town and make some banners and flyers up too and let the people know what we can do. Music industry, you are through holding us down. We are tired of staying down underground. It's time to come out. It's time to rise up. It's time to shout. We're gonna let them know what it's all about. I'm talking about music. I'm talking about making a movement. I'm talking about going all the United States of America and the rest of the world and let them know how to use the music. And I know you're with me because you've been here this long. And if we've been waiting here this long to be stronger, then we're gonna get strong. We're gonna do something with this music. Bob is gonna help us do something with this music. I know Bob is not in here every Monday night working until he can just barely stagger out that door to let this all just go down the drain. No, no. We're gonna do something with this music. Oprah Winfrey's gonna get this tape. Ricky Lake is gonna get this tape, but we're not gonna wait on Oprah Winfrey or Ricky Lake because we've got our own system we're gonna put into effect. We're gonna promote our own music yet. We're gonna distribute our own sound. I'm gonna get some CDs of ours over there in Tower Records in the local musician section so that when anybody walks in there, they can see that this truly is the land of the free. And we're in a Hotel Utah beaming the sound off to Oprah Winfrey. Yes, we're gonna let them see. Yes, we're gonna make them see. Yes, we're gonna have them see that we are the best they can be. I kid you not, we are free, the best in the world. See?
Savage, everybody. And Tomanonymous on bass. And Earl on the Fendera? On the Fendera. That's a phenomenal instrument. That was beautiful. Thank you. Thank you, Keith. All right, so we got a special treat for Keith right now. So Jeseppi and Lee are going to come on up.
Yeah.
Yes, you can carry it.
Oh, very good. How wonderful. Bring that mic down a little bit for them so that they can not have a Jeseppi mic in their face. Listen, I'd like you all to help me tonight with this. We want to send this message out. We want to send this one out to Palestine. The song is called Nothing Sacred But Love. How many people in this room have heard this song before? Yeah. Nothing Sacred, yeah. All right. So please, once it's a catchy little tune, once you catch on to it, just sort of join in. And I'll be assisted by all my friends.
I thought you were going to make a remark about Jonathan Richman.
same as whales, bittersweet. Lying places he once talked about. Where vultures come to eat. The ancients saw him, heard the voice. The incense carried in the breeze. Prince's battle. He once found.
Dub, 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 dub.
Insist for this label to imitation.
Buy from reputable dealers only.
We can do it.